Well, aren't I a popular one these days? Let's just say that I wasn't expecting some of my Doctor Who videos to blow up in the way they have. The surprising part is the rise in viewership compared to what I normally put out there. What is not really surprising, however, is the volume of ignorant comments that, in many ways, actually contradict what I've said in the videos. The most polarizing of these is my Doctor Who PR disaster video, which, in only a few weeks, has become the third most viewed video on this channel. This week, we're going to take a look at some of the comments I've received on this video, and the types of comments I've been getting are highly predictable. The focus here is third wave feminist comments, and this will probably be the first of several videos on this topic. Firstly, however, I'm going to break fandom's response with regard to the 13th Doctor into five categories. Three are perfectly reasonable, and two are not. Let's start with genuine misogynists. Those that hate the 13th Doctor simply because she is a woman. I think we can all agree that taking this approach is quite narrow-minded and bigoted. It should also be noted, however, that this is the only group we hear about from official Doctor Who channels and what some refer to as the mainstream media. The second group is the one that is either ignored or completely misrepresented, and this is the group that I fall into. This group does not have a problem with the Doctor being a woman. The concern is that this decision was highly influenced by ideology, and they have cause for concern considering the trajectory of Doctor Who in recent years with regard to third wave feminism and social justice. There are also individuals in this group that have a problem with this particular actress, not women in general. I personally think that Jodie Whittaker is good at what she's done in the past, but I don't think she has the presence to play the Doctor. Myself, and other people in this category also freely admit that we could be proven wrong on these points, but we remain skeptical. Unfortunately, this group, including myself, continually gets lumped in with the first group, despite all evidence to the contrary. The third group are Doctor Who fans and members of the general viewing public that don't really care one way or the other. To some, it's just another TV show, and others see this as a natural progression of the show and don't really pay much attention to either side of the debate. The fourth group are those that are genuinely excited about the 13th Doctor, and their excitement is free of ideological motivation. They often perceive the show as having become stale and see this as an effective way of reinvigorating it. There is nothing wrong with having this perspective, and I have actually enjoyed debating back and forth with some that fit into this category. We can generally see that, while we have a difference of opinion, we can agree to disagree. Then we have the fifth group. The group that no official media outlets focus on, the misguided and hateful ideologues. To the Doctor Who production team and mainstream media, these people don't exist. They are mythical unicorns. This group is no better than the first group, and the fact that, officially at least, they are permitted to get away with this gives many skeptical Doctor Who fans additional cause for concern. The group is almost cult-like, and their lack of objectivity can be staggering at times. To them, even the slightest proclamation of concern about the 13th Doctor means that you are a woman-hating misogynist. There is generally very little depth to their arguments, as they are more likely to repeat buzzwords and throw insults. Often, they will completely misrepresent what you have said, or will go into something that in reality has no actual bearing on the subject at hand. We're now going to take a look at some of the comments that fall into this fifth group. And in this video, the comments under examination appear to come from ideological third-wave feminists, both male and female. These are just a few representative examples of what I'm seeing over and over again and are practically taken at random. I've not included the poster's name, but I think if you're going to post it, then you should be prepared for some criticism. Here is a typical criticism of my video. Hilarious drivel, the thin veil you're using to hide your sexist opinions isn't fooling anyone with at least a few more brain cells than you. If you actually knew what a feminist meant, you'd realize why people are calling you sexist. Even if the new Doctor was terrible, I'd still be happy because little snowflakes like you feel so butthurt that they waste time making bull insert expletive videos for other like-minded snowflakes to fap over. The Doctor is a woman, and even when she regenerates into a man again in the future, she will always be a woman. Have fun in the new world, boys. This comment presents nothing of value. No argument, just a series of insults, and the now overly tired, you don't know what feminist means line. Apparently this poster doesn't either. First and second wave feminism were about equality. Third wave feminism is a hate movement. I should also note, I begin with an example of a woman who I think is capable of taking on the role. Question, why would I do this if I was a woman-hating misogynist? Next comment. Wow, thank you for informing me that patriarchy no longer exists in 2017. I guess I was just hysterically deluded to the contrary because I was on the rag. It's called the 21st century, asshole. Check it out. Better yet, get some therapy to explore your profound and pathetic misogyny. Here we have one of the constant references to the omnipresent patriarchy. Sorry, but this nebulous concept isn't really a thing. You know that, right? Next comment, and this one's a little long. Ye gods, what a bunch of whiny, mansplaining, MRA, concern trolling bullshit. It practically screams, see how legitimate my sexism is because it's presented calmly and logically through its studied delivery. Yes, I did watch the whole sad thing, and no, I'm not just another Janny come lately. I've been watching Who since I was a kid in the 80s. Seven and Ace are my doctor and companion, and I'll fight anyone who makes fun of this. Well, I don't mind the Seventh Doctor and Ace. RTD is 100% correct. It is only a small portion of fandom that is clutching its proverbial pearls over the sudden emergence of progressive politics in Doctor Who, which certainly couldn't have been there since the days of Verity, first female BBC showrunner ever, Lambert launching the show, or Russell T actually gay and feminist, unlike Stephen Moffat, Davies reviving it. It's just the internet loud minority of newly emboldened sexists coming out of the woodwork and acting like they're standing up for the Who tradition on a show that famously has no such thing. What it is by making things up as it goes for over 50 years and appeal to tradition or disingenuous defenses of masculine meritocracy betrayed amongst Whovians is laughable. I don't know if Whittaker and Chibnall are going to rock or if they are going to suck. They haven't started playing yet, so to speak. But in the fashion of any long-suffering Whovian, I'll wait to see and be cautiously optimistic. Until then, quit your bitching until there's actually something to bitch about. You sad, sorry little man. Well, first off, no, it's not just a small portion of the fan base that is showing concern. Also, yes, Doctor Who has always been progressive, but in the past it addressed legitimate issues. I'm sorry, but this is not the case with the two most recent series. Also, notice the insult at the end. When you can't argue effectively, an insult is the best way of diverting attention to this fact. Now, on to the next comment. My fake god. Well, I guess you're an atheist. The sad and pathetic lamentations of this video are just too much, as are the whines from the forever 14-year-old boys who can't handle a woman being cast. As for the claims that it's not about her, but about the show's overtly liberal slant, you don't really know the meaning of the term liberal, do you? Clearly you haven't been paying attention. Doctor Who has always had a liberal bent to it, right from the beginning, albeit more subtle. Sidney Newman, the man who created Doctor Who, and then just goes on more about Sidney Newman. Like Gene Roddenberry, he used science fiction as a social commentary. So yes, all you crying, gnashing at the teeth man babies are acting like insipid little children because you can't handle change. To you, anything that veers even a micrometer from your perceived ideas is enough to set you off on a rampage of impotent rage. It's actually quite fun to watch and also rather sad. Who knew that men, especially young men, were so fragile? I guess being older has given me a thicker skin and a more adult outlook on life. Well, not really given your comments. Simply put, boys, how about losing your collective shit over a woman being cast? Why not wait and see, then offer an uninformed opinion based on what's actually been done rather than whine because of what might be? Seriously, this crybaby nonsense is unseemly. Well, user, I might have been willing to humor some of your legitimate, and there are some legitimate concerns in here, but the insults basically invalidate your argument. Also, as you state, Gene Roddenberry used subtlety and addressed legitimate concerns. Modern Doctor Who beats you over the head with third-wave feminist and social justice talking points. Also, again, notice the insults. And next comment, it's too bad that sexist idiots like you and the quote man who made this video can't be put out of your misery. This was in response to somebody else's comment. And yep, apparently it's now acceptable to wish death on those that disagree with you. And it would be nice if I could say that this was the only comment I've received like this, but it isn't. Here's another pearl of wisdom. Talk about misogynist spinning of nothing into something. The boys' club is still pouting. Pathetic. It's just insert blank TV show about an alien who travels through time in a phone booth. Get over yourself. You think you sound intelligent because you speak well. You sound like a sad loser. If you had a life, you wouldn't have time to obsess over imaginary people, extraterrestrials. Well, I do have a life, and no, I don't have a lot of time on my hands. But here's that pesky male privilege thing again. These are only a few examples, and there are many, many more. The comment section on my PR disaster video now numbers in the thousands. It's now at the point that I don't have the time to sort through them anymore, and the comment section has taken on a life of its own. I will probably do several videos of this sort when I have the time. In closing, I'd like to present this comment from my last video on the subject. I think you are pushing an agenda to some degree, just because your old videos were normal. If you look at your videos recently, all the ones with over 100 views are not the same as your old ones, and you know. Again, I'm not pushing an agenda. If I were, I'd be amongst those that are denouncing the 13th Doctor wholesale. As for the style, yes, these videos are distinctly different from what I've done in the past, and there are reasons for this. Firstly, these videos are scripted because I want to be exact with my arguments, and this will obviously lead to a narrative style. Also, regarding style, not content, this is a change that I've been wanting to make for a while. Back in 2014, I put this channel on hiatus for 6 months to deal with personal issues. I put up a video, which is no longer public on this channel, where I stated that when I returned, this channel would be very different stylistically. This was what I had in mind. Unfortunately, it would be another 3 years before I actually implemented this change. I've been doing YouTube for a very long time, and have largely been doing the same thing over and over again. The only real change has been production quality in terms of video and sound, particularly when I switched to 1080 at 60 frames per second 2 years ago. My content, however, has remained largely the same. I needed to try something different. But I also think it's important to note that you will still see videos presented in my traditional style being uploaded alongside these. I haven't dropped this style. My regular videos are still present on this channel, and I will continue to make them as long as my channel exists. But I also needed to try something new. And that's it for this video. So as always, everyone, thank you for watching and have a good day.